God's blessing be upon us. And may God protect us from the enemy that would try to steal this word from us. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. As most of you are aware, my wife comes from a Greek family. May have heard about the room, my big fat Greek wedding a few years ago. Her family's not that fat, but they are big. There's a lot of them, and they're all kind of small like her. There's a lot of them. And I remember when I first met her, I would say, well, how are you related to so-and-so when they were at the house? And she would go, well, they're kind of a cousin by... And through the process of trying to figure this out, I learned a word. It was kubadi. Kubadi. Kubadi in the Greek language, in the culture, just means I'm family. Well, how are you family? Well, kubadi. Well, what does that mean? What is kubadi? Basically, stop asking. We're family. We may not even be blood related. We're family. We are connected. We are connected. On Stallion Sunday, that was working on this passage of scripture this week, I was thinking about the family relationship. We have a mother-in-law that's lifted up in this passage of scripture. And as we read this, it's now Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with fever. So we knew exactly how they were related. That was an easy one. But at some level, it was a relationship built upon who he married. They were a family, but they were extended family. There was a mother-in-law, and I was thinking about that because people ask me all the time, well, how do scouts relate to the church? And I'll say, well, they're part of ministry, and they'll explain how that connects and make sense of that for me. And I'm like, well, they're part of the ministry. And it's sometimes really hard to put it all together to explain what it means that they're part of ministry. But I always want to say, well, they're kubadi. They're kubadi. They're part of the family. They're doing the work of ministry sometimes that we want to do and sometimes that we don't want to do. They're extending our ministry. But I like today's passage of scripture because it really helped me understand a better way of understanding than just saying, well, you're part of our ministry. Because it says they went and Jesus went to the mother-in-law, and I love how this Mark's pretty. This is Mark chapter 1. This is the beginning, but it says, now Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with fever, and immediately they told him of her, and he came and took her by the hand and lifted her up, and the fever left her, and she served him. I mean, it's like one sentence. He came, put his hand out, touched her, lifted her up, and she was made well. And then that evening at sundown, they brought him in. And she served them. And he came and took her by the hand and lifted her up, and fever left her, and she served them. So Jesus came into her presence, to the mother-in-law, healed her, and she immediately began to serve. One of the things I love about this passage of scripture is that there's nowhere in here that we know about the mother-in-law's faith, her practice of religion, what kind of person is she good or bad, or has she done all kinds of terrible things? Is this a sickness she brought on herself because she didn't take care of herself, because maybe she should have taken some medicine or been more cognizant about what she was eating? She shouldn't have stayed away. We don't know any of that kind of stuff. We know that she was sick, and we know that Jesus went to her and Jesus healed her. I think about that in terms of our scouting ministry, because one of the things about scouts, you guys, the first time most of our scouts came here, I would say almost all of them, there was never a test when you came in. Well, how do you believe in God? And what does that mean that you believe in God? And tell me about your faith. It's part of the principles of scouting, and there's an expectation we'll talk about that. But we don't want to know about that to begin with. We expect you're going to learn and grow into that. We all come in a way broken and hurting and sick. Much like the mother-in-law of Simon. We come needing to be healed, but not even knowing how to say, heal us, Lord. Somebody else has to go and get Jesus for us and bring Jesus to us. And one of the things I love about our scouting ministry is that we have the opportunity to bring Jesus to the scouting ministry. The job of scouts isn't to bring Jesus, but thank God we have people that want to make it a glorious and a secret mission. I like that. You're not the only one of these gals. I've met some of you other ones. You have a secret mission, and I appreciate that. It's okay. But it's also our job as a church to bring that to them, to bring Jesus into the mix and to say, we're here to lift you up, to lift out a hand and say, stand up and walk with us. And one of the things I love about this passage of Scripture is that, again, first, we don't know anything about this woman's faith background. We assume she's Jewish and she grew up in a Jewish set. How we don't know how strong her faith is. We know that Jesus came and healed her. And in her healing, she immediately began to serve. She immediately began to serve. She was cooking dinner, I would assume, at that point. That's kind of the job that they had. But it's not because she was a woman she was cooking dinner. It was because she felt the need that she, once she found out that she was in a relationship with Jesus Christ and that Jesus healed her, that she needed to do something in response to that. And that's what I see happening with our scouting ministry, particularly here at Bank United Methodist Church, is that young men, young women, and as importantly, the leaders of these young men and young women come to the church not always having this deep and abiding faith, but a want to be with youth and to work with youth and to help them to grow. And then while they're here, they find out that that's not quite enough for them, that they need something else. They want to take a next step, and they want to serve in a new way. And then while they're here, Jesus comes near to them, reaches out his hand and lifts them up, and they're ready to serve. And what I've seen happen in this church, that in the 4 years that I've been here, it has been kind of amazing that the most evangelistic area of our church is our scouting ministry. I don't know the exact numbers right now, but over the 4 years I've been here, there have been times, and it's pretty close to it now. I didn't do the numbers quite recently, but over half of our new members have come in a direct relationship to scouting ministry. That's a pretty extravagant number. A third of our confirmation class last year came to us through scouting ministry. And what's really interesting to me is that these folks, you folks are coming into the church and we're making this available to you, and we're saying, well, you're a part of the ministry, but we're finding out that as soon as Jesus comes to them and says, what, stand up, work with us, they become members of the church, and you start to look at the people who are in leadership in the church now, a lot of them are coming from the ranks of scouting. They're ready to serve. They've been trained in service. Now they're ready to serve in a new way. So, as I said before, the word that I learned was kubata. That you're part of the family. But another word I learned after that was you're not just part of the family, that you're loved as if you were, as you are loved as if you are a part of us. You are loved as if you are a part of us. And that phrase is agape mou. You're agape mou. That we are one in this together. And I love this passage of Scripture again because the mother-in-law was healed, not because of her strong faith, but because Jesus saw somebody who was hurting and lifted them up. Jesus sees a hurting people, a hurting country, a hurting community. Jesus sees us in our pain, in our brokenness, and reaches out to lift us up. He does it in other places besides scouting ministry, but today we're talking about the scouting ministries. And I see it happen all the time with this group of people. I see it happen all the time that Jesus reaches out and lifts up. We saw it this morning with the children, young people who will stand in front of a group of people and share what's going on in their faith journey, reading scripture, playing the piano, sharing that gift. Some people think I might over defend or over talk about how great our scouting ministry is. I don't defend scouting ministry because I think scouting is wonderful and great. It may be or may not be. I defend it here because they're doing the job sometimes the church refuses to do. They're doing a job of raising up our children. You look at that list of people and God and me, all these children who've come forward and have learned about about Jesus and their relationship with Jesus. I defend them because they are working with young people and helping them to be raised in a godly life. I'll tell you when I'll stop defending scouts is when that stops happening, and not until then. But this, you're doing a good job. And you're teaching us, and we're leading each other, and we're finding ways that we can serve each other. Because the truth is, Christ has reached out and lifted you up. But he's also reaching his hand into other parts of the church, and we're seeing the example. And we're living by that example. And I pray that God will continue to do that for us. And then we will go from just being, oh, they're just a ministry, to being, they are us. We are each other. That this is, you will say, this is my church. And we will say, this is our ministry. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.